One of the interesting things for people to do as they are studying the Bible is to ask some very serious questions. And I believe that oftentimes people don't ask the right questions, and they're not asking questions that really the Bible is trying to point out. Remember, it's the Bible is written from a perspective to help us understand who the creator of the universe is and what he has done for us. And so I have to ask questions. Do I understand the basic facts of a passage, such as what does this word mean? We understand words have meaning, don't they? And so if I'm really going to understand this book, then I need to understand what it means. What does this word mean? What was that human author seeking to get across? Why was Matthew writing to reach the Jewish people? Why did Mark try to reach the Roman people? Why was Luke writing to the Greeks? And how would the Greeks receive this message of a Messiah? All these things are important, and they have to be asked if we're really going to understand. One of the books that I remember reading when I was in high school was The Great Gatsby by F. Scott Fitzgerald. And I remember in that class, I don't remember a whole lot of, especially English classes, right? But I remember in that class, for whatever reason, that book captured my attention. I still don't know why to this day. But that book captured my attention, and I remember as I was reading that book, or going through that book, I was intrigued by it. That was really the first book that I ever really picked up and said, I'm interested in reading this. Not just because I need to get a good grade or at least pass the class, but I'm actually interested in what this book is about. And some of the things that we had to ask ourselves were questions about what was his intention? Why was he writing this? Who was he writing it about? I remember The Scarlet Letter by Nathaniel Hawthorne. And that Scarlet Letter reminded me, hey, who is this Hester Prynne individual? What does she do? What is all this about? Why was this being written? And the poetical structure of that. Well, the Bible is no different. Again, these human authors, we have to understand, why were they writing this? What perspective, what background is going on? What was going on in their day? Where were they writing this from? Who were they writing this to? That's what's known as observation. Then from the observation, then we can go to some interpretation. Now we can try to understand in its own historical setting what it means. And then I can put it into my own day. How does this now apply in my current day, in my current context? Does the book of Genesis have anything to do with me, though this was written thousands of years before Jesus Christ? About thousands of years of human history. And so the questions that we need to walk away from tonight is, really, what is the Bible? Is this God's word, or is this man's word? I realize we deal with skeptics. We have people who are constantly questioning the validity and the reliability of the Word of God. And therefore, it becomes really a matter of faith. Do I believe it? There are people who would rather have more faith in something that is unproven than in something that in all reality proves itself. How did we get this? Where did it come from? How do we know that it can be trusted? Can we use the Bible for our everyday problems and situations? Can I say the Bible is not simply a bunch of stories that are good to read to your kids at bedtime. The Bible is not just a self-help book. The Bible is not simply a tool that you can use to say, hey, if you want to get rich, here's some schemes that you can go to. Here's some things you can use. The Bible is about a God who loves you and has chosen to reveal himself to you so that you and I can get to know him and his heart. The Bible helps us understand who we are and why we need this God in our lives. If you don't know who God is, can I say it begins by knowing the Bible and what he says about himself. And what you will discover is that this Bible, this book, not only tells you about who he is, but it tells you about who you are and what God has done to help us. Every single person needs this book. And yet, how many of us have numerous copies of it and never open its pages? As I close, again, we have seen that the Bible is a book of books. This is a library written by numerous human authors from different styles, but all revealing one plan, one story, one purpose, and that is the salvation of mankind through Jesus Christ. And so as I close here tonight, I want us to simply consider, what is the Bible in your life? I don't know your spiritual condition, but what I do know is that whatever it is, God has an answer for. His word. Let's pray. Father, thank you so much for your word. I pray that you would help us, God, to understand the importance and the significance of your word. God, thank you for giving it to us. It's holy men of God. Spake, wrote, as they were moved by the Holy Ghost. God, thank you for revealing yourself to us and revealing your desire, God, to save us from our sin. Pray now that you will help us, God, to understand more